Ready?
Yeah.
Cole?
Okay, I'm recording.
Now concentrate, Jodie. Tell me if you feel anything in particular about any of these objects.
See anything I did?
Thank you, Dad. It's so pretty.
Open it.
Was her music box.
Laura.
Yeah. Nathan? Okay, I'll tell him. Nathan, someone named Ryan Clayton is here to see you. He says you know what it's about.
Yes. I'll be back in a moment.
Do you know this guy who's come to see Nathan?
No idea.
I hope we don't finish too late. I have tons of homework to do. You know, Nathan's always complaining when I get bad grades. He's always keeping me here when I should be studying.
That's a discussion you'll have to have with him, Princess.
I'm so hungry. When do we get a break?
Yeah, I'm hungry too. We need to get Nathan out of here for once. Somewhere fancy. I'm sick of cafeteria food.
Do you think he'll be long?
Relax, Princess. He'll be back in a minute.
Hasn't Nathan been... I don't know, just... like, acting kind of strange lately?
He's trying to raise money for the lab at the moment. Maybe he's worried about it. You know how he is. Hey, where are you going? Aren't you gonna wait for Nathan?
Listen, I never get around to telling her I need more time.
No. Professor Dawkins, she needs to come with me today. I have my orders.
Christ, she's only a child. My assistant and I are the only family she's got. She doesn't have any idea what's out there.
Look, Dawkins, I see your side of it. All right, I do. But orders are orders, right? You gonna bring her to me, or do I have to go and get her?
Jodie, Could you come here, please?
What's going on, Nathan? You look upset.
Jodie, this is Ryan Clayton from the CIA. The agency wants you to join their military school program at Camp Perry. Ryan's going to take care of you from now on. You have to go with him, Jodie. Today.
Understand. Why me?
This unit belongs to the CIA. They've been tracking your case ever since you arrived. They know what you and Aiden can do.
I am not a child. I can make my own decisions. No one can force me to go.
Okay, Jodie, I know. It's difficult, but you need to understand. This is a great opportunity for you.
No one can tell me what to do with my life.
Jesus, listen up, Miss Holmes. I don't give a shit about your pathetic adolescent pouting, all right? You can rant and rave all you want, but you'll shut your mouth and do as you're told.
I'll go get my things.
Only the essentials. We've got everything you need at Camp Perry.
Thank you.
Don't worry. I'm sure you'll be great. Dang. I'm gonna miss the hell out of you, princess.
I'll come and see you as soon as I can. I'll never let you down. You know that, don't you? I'll always be there for you.
Time to go.
Yeah?
Jodie. Hey, it's Ryan.
Ryan!
I was just wondering if you got my email.
What email?
The one I sent 3 days ago.
You know, I've actually been having problems with my computer. What was the email about?
Dinner, tonight, fancy restaurant. Anyway, it's too late now, so... maybe another time?
Shit, I'm so sorry. Why don't you just come over here for dinner tonight? I mean, you wanted to see my apartment anyway, so...
Sure, but I...
How about around 8?
Okay. Yeah, I'll bring a kick-ass bottle of wine. See you later.
Now I get why you blasted my computer. You didn't want me to see Ryan. It's not your call, Aiden. I can do what I want. Fuck this! We're not gonna start this again! I'm not yours, Aiden! I can have a relationship with whoever I want. This is my life. Okay, do you fucking hear me? This is my life. You know what? I happen to think Ryan is great. He's charming, he's intelligent, he's funny. And I think I'm falling for him. Okay. It's 7 o'clock. I have an hour to make dinner, tidy up, and make myself look. Books. Okay, on the bookshelf. Okay, great. All right, dirty clothes in the basket in the bathroom. All right, there. bed. Oh my God, the dinner. Okay, there's got to be something in the kitchen. Come on, Aiden, don't be a pain in the ass. Right, the trash can in the kitchen. Yeah, the trash can. I gotta find something I can make in 1 hour with what's ever left in the fridge. Asian beef, I mean, that looks good. It's not too complicated. Curried chicken with oven-baked vegetables. It'll take some time in the oven, but it seems doable. Pizza delivery. I mean, it's not exactly gourmet, but no preparation, no mess. I mean, it could be an option. Yeah, chicken curry, with a little down-home flavor. I mean, he's gonna love that. I mean, as long as I don't fuck it up. Oh, crap. Crap, he's early. I'm coming! Oh, good one, Aiden. Okay, you got me. Now, open the door. Aiden! Aiden, come on, open up! Play games? I can play too. You know, you're wasting your time, Aiden. You're not gonna stop me from seeing Ryan. Thanks, Aiden. So far, so good. Ginger. It's supposed to be an aphrodisiac. I mean, it's not in the recipe, but can't hurt. I mean, I need all the help I can get. Well, into the oven we go. Christ, Aiden. Look, you just don't get it. Gotta change. What should I wear? Oh, hi, Ryan. I've been waiting for you. He is gonna see a whole new side of me. You might as well just give up, Aiden. Okay? This date is going on. Period. I didn't behave yourself. Okay, this is important to me, and I'm counting on you.
Chateau Margaux, 2001. The guy in the store said it was a pretty good year.
That sounds good to me, so. Why don't you sit? I'll get the thing that opens the wine.
Cool apartment.
Huh? Yeah, thanks. Aiden, for fuck's sakes.
You want me to open it?
No, no, I'll do it.
Okay. To your new apartment.
To my new apartment.
Wow, so when did you move in?
A couple weeks ago. Yeah, the agency found it for me and all furnished and everything, which is... It's actually the first place I've ever had, just by myself, so... It's weird getting used to the idea of it. And how about you? Where do you live?
Oh, I have a place just outside of town. Yeah, it's small, but, you know, it's got a little garden and it's pretty quiet.
And did you grow up here?
No, I was born in Oregon. Now my parents and brother still live there. But I moved out when I was 16.
16? Oh. Did you get kicked out or something?
Well, things were pretty chaotic at home. my stepfather liked to beat me when he had too much to drink. And I just decided to get out before one of us went too far.
How did you end up joining the CIA?
I went through college, not really knowing what I wanted to do. Tried the army. You know, looked for the action, travel, adventure. Long enough to realize that wasn't for me. And when a CIA agent recruiter approached me, I jumped at it.
I should probably, you know, I'm gonna go check on the dinner because this cooking thing, it's a whole new adventure for me.
You need help?
No, but why don't you go sit and more wine would be nice.
Okay. Mmm, smells good.
Oh, it's chicken curry with oven-baked vegetables. That's what it's supposed to be, so.
I didn't know you cooked. I mean, it looks great. Good.
Good. I'm glad. I'm glad you like it.
So we've been working together now for what? Like 2 years? I know almost nothing about you.
Well, I mean, there's nothing much to say. You know, I grew up with my parents on the DPA campus, and then Nathan looked after me, and well, I mean, you pretty much know the rest, so.
Parents, do you still see them?
No, I don't. I think they were just terrified about how different I was. So Nathan and Cole, they brought me up more or less. They taught me how to cope with Aiden, how to accept myself as I am. I mean, it wasn't always easy, but you know, I'm making progress.
You know, did Nathan ever manage to explain to you why you have this link with Aiden?
No. I mean, not really. I mean, they learned a lot of stuff about the infra world. Really not much about Aiden. I mean, I don't think even he knows who or what he is.
It's like, is he here now, you know, listening to us and...
Yeah. Yeah, he never leaves me. What about you? Do you have any family here?
No. My parents are still in Oregon. Go to see them as little as possible.
And are you married or anything?
No. Wait. Yes, I mean, I was. You know, my ex-wife and I have been separated for 2 years. And, yeah, it couldn't work. I mean, in the end, it didn't. You know, we had our good times, but eventually we decided to go our separate ways. How about you? Anyone on your radar?
I've got Aiden, so...
I mean, anyone in our world.
You know, Aiden kind of has always made people run away. Or maybe it's me. Maybe I'm just too odd for anyone to be interested in.
You're special, Jodie. Aiden's got nothing to do with this.
Hey, Aiden. Thank you.